Superintendent, there was a stay for our service disruption. Deputy Bigman, no, the intruder.
Carry on. The underwear? Was he wearing them at the time of his death or dressed afterwards?
I can't be sure.
Defensive wounds?
None.
No cuts or bruises to his hands, but his ribs? Every single rib is broken.
I don't want any details leaking. Make that understood.
Yes, sir.
You confirm only an elderly gentleman has been killed.
Marilyn. I swear to you, this had nothing to do with his business.
His business? We all know that. I've been through the entire contents of the house. It was a robbery, no question. Aside from the Lexus, a great deal of money was stolen. While I was away, Lee's secretary delivered $2,000. That's missing, along with two leather coats, two suits, some inconsequential pieces of jewelry. Lee had gold coins. He gave them as gifts. They're unusual and should be easy to trace should the culprit try to pawn them. And a dozen pairs of new Selka black socks. Aren't you going to write this down?
I'll have an officer take your statement.
Marilyn, this is Superintendent Rodriguez.
I know who he is. I happen to be friends with a great many police officers. Do you think I called 911 earlier? No. I called Commander Ettore DeVito, who was present at the Wallenberg Award celebration a few weeks ago, and asked to speak to him directly.
We're all here for you.
Lee was alone in the house. He was vulnerable. It was an opportunistic attack. He wears a hearing aid, did you know?
No, I didn't.
Oh, the burglar could have easily surprised him. Poor Lee, he wouldn't have had a chance. He wouldn't have fought back.
Mrs. Miglin, maybe we can talk at another time.
Talk now, why not?
There were certain items beside your husband's body.
What items?
Pornographic magazines. Homosexual pornographic magazines.
I see. Well, they must belong to the killer.
It would mean he brought the magazines in with him.
I'm not interested in his intentions. Find him, catch him. But don't talk to me about what might or might not be going through his mind.
I understand.
The killer took a bath and shaved?
Yeah, he might have stayed the night.
He must have known when Marilyn was coming home. Where did you get those?
Mrs. Miglin? It's very thoughtful of you, but there's really no need to buy my men food.
Oh, I didn't buy it. It was donated by Gibson's Steakhouse on Rush Street. They're friends of the family. They wanted to help.
I'm sorry, we haven't been introduced.
Oh, this is Duke, my son.
I'm Superintendent Rodriguez. Sorry for your loss.
Duke's flown in from California. He's a Hollywood actor.
Aspiring to be.
No, well, you've had roles. Good roles. Tell him about the film you're in.
Air Force One. It's going to be released this summer.
Yep. Starring Harrison Ford.
Coming out July 25th.
Mm. He plays a pilot.
A Russian pilot. There are lots of pilots in the movie.
He's at the beginning of a great career.